Well, as we're getting started again, I just want to say welcome to our day two of 3 days of prayer, and we'll conclude tomorrow, but we won't stop praying. We're going to keep praying every day, every hour, as often as God prompts us, right? But these focus days are meant to be just days to again center our hearts and minds on the Lord as we have entered 2021. I'm going to go ahead and just direct you, and I'm going to see if I can to share a few thoughts about today's word, intercession. I'm going to stop this music for a second, so just bear with me. Okay. So I'm going to just point us to this prayer guide, and I'm going to read one of the verses. I'll do another share here. Okay, did I get it right this time? You guys see my screen?
Yep, we can see it.
Okay. So this is day two, and we're talking about intercession and petition specifically. Obviously, last night we prayed and had intercession, prayers for others. But thanks again to Coco for working out these notes. And I know you and Dottie got your heads together on some good ideas here for these days. But I'd like to just read, if you're looking at the psalm with me, I'd like to focus on verses 18 and 19. And remember these words from Psalm 145, 18 and 19. God's there, listening for all who pray, and mean it. He does what's best for those who fear him. Hears them call out and saves them. God sticks by all who love him. And another version of the Bible called the Message. Isn't that right, Coco? You got these. I like that version, to, especially on a prayer time, just to really get to the heart of God's heart for us. And as we think about prayer, and so I just wanted to read those verses, and again point you to the prayer guide. You can even bring it up on your own. I won't be sharing this the whole time. And just a reminder today, as we pray a little bit later, we're going to focus on prayers for our church today, and obviously other prayers of intercession. But think about these key areas of our ministry that many of you are vitally a part of in so many ways, either volunteering or serving or ministering, and lifting up our church family. So we'll focus on, we've already started today praying for children's ministry and all those that help volunteering in various ways in the church. And now here we are, 10 a.m., join the meeting. Here you are for prayer, singing, and sharing. So I'm going to pray, and then we're going to hear a song called Prayer by Mike, our worship leader. So I thought it was good because it has this focus on that acronym ACTS, Adoration, Confession, Thanksgiving, and Supplication or Intercession, as we focus on that today. So let's pray, and we'll give this time to the Lord. Father, thank you for this morning. Thank you for an opportunity to be with these brothers and sisters in Christ. And Lord, as we again are entering this day, we are thankful for a new day in the midst of all the seasons we're going through in our country and our world, and right here in our own church too. God, we're thankful that you reign, and that you call us to pray, to make a difference, to pray, to act, to bless, and just give us that heart for you. And as we lift up prayers for others, both close by, as well as throughout our country and our world, in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Okay, and I gotta ask, well, I'm gonna go ahead and share this song now that Mike has prepared for us. And again, based on this acronym ACTS and a song called Prayer. So let's listen and see if I can make that.
There, this is Mike from Community of Hope.
Everybody here, Mike?
I'm glad you're here at 3 Days of Prayer. I have a fun song that I learned oh so many years ago. It's by Stephen Curtis Chapman, and it says a lot of great things about prayer. And the song is called Let Us Pray. I'd like to share it with you now. Trouble in the making. You ask if I'll be praying for you, please. And in keeping with convention, I say yes with good intentions to pray later, making mention of your needs. But Since we have this moment here at heaven's door, we should start knocking now. What are we waiting for? Let us pray, let us pray. Everywhere and every way, every moment of the day, it is the right time. For the Father above, He is listening with love, and He wants to answer us, so let us pray.
Here's the one prayer.
Thank you guys so much for being here at this 3 days of prayer for 2021. I'd like to share a song that follows a prayer format. It follows the acronym ACTS, like the book of the Bible.
Okay?
It stands for Adoration, okay. Confession, Thanksgiving, and Supplication. And it's a neat format that helps you in your prayer life and in your prayer walk. If you just don't know where to start, start with adoration. Adore God. Go into confession where you remember that we need God for His forgiveness. And then thanksgiving, which is kind of the fun part. And then supplication, which is asking for things for yourself or for others. So this song follows that pattern. And I just wanted to share with you today as we celebrate this 3 days of prayer.
Let your
again, thank you to Mike. Grateful for his participation in this. In this way, he recorded several songs, and grateful that he could help us out in this way. And I was going to share a bit of his testimony and just some prayer insights that he has, just sharing what God's been doing in his life. But thank you, Jono, for being here. I'd like to just pray for you, just as you share and your awesome growing family. So great to have you with us. But let's pray. Lord, I thank you for so many who serve in our church in a variety of ways, right here in this Zoom room, so many that give and serve. And thankful for Jono, for his gifts of music that he uses to glorify you. And just thank you for his heart to share and to give us a word from his heart today. Bless him and keep him and his family in Jesus' name. Amen.
I found that if I start earlier at work, not just my work is better, because the grocery store, I'm a sales rep, for those of you that don't know, for Specialty Grocery and our accounts at Fred Meyer, even though I don't work for Fred Meyer or Kroger, but I'm there doing like physical work, like putting product to the shelf, and then I order product. I've got to pull the stuff off that's outdated. I'm in three different departments. There's a lot of items, just all over the store. There's probably thousands of items per store, but it's not as hard as you think. A lot of it's visual. I just look, kind of have to fight against the folks facing stuff. A lot of them are young, don't know what they're doing, don't really care, some of them. And just got to deal with that. And so the earlier I get there, there's always something going on.
Yeah, you're around a lot of people in your day-to-day work life, and I know it's we've talked about this challenging time. Tell me what's on your heart, just as you and Dottie spoke, and we were doing these 3 days of prayer, but tell us what's your...
I'll mention real brief, just because it happened just yesterday, or 2 days ago, actually. Sometimes I'm in a serious rush when I go in, especially early, and by serious, I mean I'll stand there with product if somebody's in my way and almost like take a step, like, doing everything I can without saying something like, hey, I need to get there. I really need you to move right now, and I'll walk around like somebody could run and maybe keep up with my walk. Like that's how fast I'm walking. Like I just burn around the store. And I said something about playing piano at church and doing that along with this job and how grateful I am. And this lady poured out her heart about the things that she does at her church for about 15 minutes. And that's an eternity in the morning when customers aren't there yet. And I was literally like dancing in my boots a couple of times, but I just thought, God really wants me to, I feel like he really wants me to listen to this woman. She poured out so much that she was actually starting to get emotional. And I was just like, wow, this is how much people long to be back at church, to be around fellowship. And I really felt for her. So I couldn't do anything else except for just stand there and really listen to her. So I guess that's sort of my way of, I let you guys know that, sometimes when you stand there and really listen to somebody, even though you don't know them that well, I mean, what an extraordinary thing that was. Really helped increase my faith to see that God is moving. And I haven't always agreed with that woman. We haven't always seen eye to eye. We've had some kind of instances where we're just like, she's doing stuff I don't really like, or, she's kind of being rude.
But look at that bond. Once you started talking about church, it's again, that bond in Christ. Other differences, we see differences, all of us, as we think about it. But look at that bond that we have in Christ.
Yeah, and sometimes I don't mention, like, excuse me, have you accepted Jesus as your personal sin? Like, I don't come right up and say that, but maybe you just say, God bless you, or just mentioning God just in any way, and it gets somebody kind of, and then maybe they will expound.
Yes.
I've had that happen.
Opening the door. Yeah. Letting
I wanted to mention that because that was a powerful thing that happened the other day, and I was really moved by it. But in regards to my boss, I had mentioned his daughter, and I've got her name here. Her name is Stella Grace. And I love that her middle name is Grace. Now, he's very skeptical about a relationship with God, or things that are spiritual in nature. He's kind of a more, I see it, I believe it, you know, material, physical kind of, you know, belief in things, which is unfortunately quite common with a lot of folks these days. And it's difficult to explain to someone like that why we feel the way we feel and do what we do as Christians, and you know, the different forms of love, and not just saying love just as a random word that's meaningless, but actually knowing that there is a love for God and a love for your friends and a love for your spouse. And, you know, there's really in-depth stuff, as we've all, you know, I think Doug and I think you did a sermon once on the forms of love too, Pastor John. But anyhow, his daughter Stella Grace was having a lot of trouble. I think she's 9 or 10 years old. They were in the hospital. Their bills were being run up. This was pre-COVID, and they were really struggling. He was struggling with his relationship with his wife. He was angry. He was tired. You know, he was kind of at his wit's end for things. And I know that there were a lot of prayers going out for this young girl. And he said that they went to the hospital not long after the prayers started. I don't know, maybe a couple weeks, maybe a little more. And he said things got so incredibly better that they didn't need to go to the hospital as much anymore.
Wow.
And I had prayed for myself. I had prayed myself just to say, you know, God, we could use this situation for him to really open his eyes a bit. And just the collective praying, I feel, that took part, he is so much more open now to hearing what I have to say about my faith. Wow. And he doesn't really look at, like, oh, obviously the prayers were the things that fix all of this. You know, he's sort of on board, but he's still kind of like, yeah, I need proof of this and of that. But he has crossed this huge gap of being able to actually see why I have faith the way I do, and what's going on with Jesus. You know, why I say to him sometimes, like, you know, Jesus is so important. Anyhow, just opening that conversation up with him, it's been extraordinary to watch, to see that change happen. And his relationship with his wife has gotten better. You know, things have gotten better for him. Yeah. And most importantly, you know, for his daughter to be a healthier little girl has been, you know, extraordinary. So
amazing.
Thank you so much for your prayers. Yeah. It really made a difference.
Well,
still making a difference.
Thank you for being a prayerful man. That I often think, as you shared about the first story about the other woman that you talked about, that, you know, ministry is found oftentimes in what we call the interruptions of life. Okay. It's not always in the most, let's just say, convenient time. We have our schedule, and even at church as a pastor, these things I got to get done, yet things come up. And people need care or ministry or prayer. And that's sometimes the most powerful moments in the, like I call it, what the world calls the interruptions, right? But they're the God moments where God breaks through. And I'm sure you've all found that to be true in some form or another too. Yeah. And then you never know what we might be able to do, as you think about that second story, for someone just by a word, an action, tell them we'll pray for them. Even the most skeptical person, God will take that little piece of faith, that little seed of faith that we offer up. And who knows, even with your boss, hey, it's maybe not an immediate conversion in 2 seconds, but it's God's at work, right? Prayers, yeah, Jono. Thank you for sharing that, Jono, and that testimony of the power of prayer. And of just entering into God's presence, whether it's in a grocery store, whether it's at church, whether it's who knows where, out on the ball field with our kids or grandkids, we never know, right?
I wanted to mention one more thing, if you don't mind. I can't help but think of the Good Samaritan story of the guy on the side of the road that's just, you know, robbed and beaten up and laying there and passing by on the other side of the road. And I could have done that. I could have said, you know what, I'm real busy here. And I was busy. But sometimes God calls us to stop. And it's amazing when that happens. Anyhow, just wanted to like to look at scripture for stuff like that.
You all can follow, and John, you can know too. We're going to thank you for that testimony, and we're going to just enter into a time of prayer and allow the those that wish to pray to pray in a moment here. But and let's remember to pray for Mike. And I didn't get the gal's name. Maybe John can bring it back. The woman that he was talking with a few days ago too, that we might pray for her as well. But intercession, how powerful that is, and we need to pray and pray for all in need and all people everywhere. And so I'm gonna just again shift us to a time of prayer, and this is where too I'll open up for anyone that wishes to pray. I'm going to direct you again to the prayer list, and I'll see if I can bring it up one more time. Okay, so you might have seen already, but just I know everybody came in at different points. I'm not sure who all saw it, but today was a day especially to pray for the church. And it does say for our church here, but I'd like to think about too the church of Jesus throughout the world that we would pray for, and maybe with some of these key themes in mind for children and youth and obviously our staff. We are so grateful for your prayers for our Hope staff and missions. That's again that global picture. Our ministries of teaching, adult ministry, children's ministry, youth ministry, prayer ministry. But let your heart just lead you as you pray. And even our individual church family, there's people that we have in mind that I know that need prayer. And again, our world is going through such turmoil right now, and we need, again, covering. And so just what is on your heart to pray for? I just want to open up that time for us to pray. And maybe if Dottie or Coco, if you have any other insights or words before we pray, I just want to invite that. And again, if anybody wishes to speak as we pray, just invite you to turn the microphone on or off as you pray or as you end your prayer, so that we can hear one another too. So any other thoughts, Dottie or Coco, as we open up this prayer time?
I would like to add to everybody's prayers the prayers of praise. Walter and I, while we were driving, prayed that we were so grateful for the beautiful ways that the Lord has sustained us personally through this year. It's amazing to me how gracious God has been. And I am so delighted to see everybody in this prayer time, fully knowing that there are others who are praying and we don't know, but we do know God is listening. God is hearing. God is acting. And I thank you for joining us in this prayer time. This is beautiful.
Thank you. Thank you.
And I was just thinking this morning that testimony that Dave gave last night about praying for safety and how he really saw that the Lord kept his grandson or son safe on that motorcycle accident. And I just realized that in these times of not being with our families as much, that God really is keeping our families safe, and how we need to praise him for that and be aware of the fact that he's at work, even if we don't see it as closely as we normally do in a non-COVID life. So I give him praise and thanksgiving this morning for keeping us safe and for keeping his hand squarely upon each one of us as his children.
Yeah, that's a great, great entrance into prayer, being thankful and praying again for those that we love. So thank you for that. And again, I'll open with a short prayer, and then just want to invite you to join in prayer as you feel so led. May have some slight, just quiet background music so that just might be meditative and prayerful as we open this time. And we'll after we pray, we'll close with another final song as well. So. Let's pray together. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we are blessed in so many ways. And just as we've heard from Jono share, just blessed to be used by you to be a light, to bring hope. And whether it's a conversation with someone that's hurting, even in inconvenient times, Lord, use us to be your messengers and to be your listening ears. Those that we encounter are maybe far from you. We just thankful for that example of even Jono's boss, Mike, and the prayers for Stella Grace, and just how you're working even in this man's life that's struggling, but yet is seeing you. We believe and pray that you're breaking through his heart to soften his heart that he might receive you. And so thankful for these good words and just the reminders again, as Dottie and Coco have shared, to be in prayer, be thankful for just deliverance from any difficult times, whether it's driving or family or other challenges or just heightened times that we go through in just day-to-day things, activities, or specific concerns for our family. We now lift up prayers, Lord, and just hear us, whether we pray out loud. I just thank you for those that in our heart to pray out loud and to share a concern, or just praying quietly within our own hearts. Now, hear us as we pray. Thank you, Lord. Again, I just invite you to pray as you may feel led, and just unmute that microphone and speak a word. It could just be a sentence or even just a name if you wish to pray in that way.
Church and all the families represented there, the history of that church, all the people that went before us, and all the people that you're calling in for our future. Lord, I pray for the leadership of the church, for the for Pastor John, and for Coco, and for Dana, for Hillary, and all those, for Jono, and for Mike. I just appreciate all their efforts, Lord, and I pray that you'll continue to inspire them and fill them with your Holy Spirit as they continue to thrive in the environment that you've given us, Lord, to be called. Lord, just pray for the church, pray for all the families represented there, and pray that your Holy Spirit be upon that place, and that as we go through this time of COVID, that will continue to thrive, and that your Holy Spirit will expand our ministry and show us the way that you would have us to go, Lord. I pray for the community and all the families represented. Praise you, Lord. Praise you for parents. Praise you for all that you've done, and pray your Holy Spirit into that place, in Jesus' name.
Jesus, we thank you for giving us this time We thank you for each other. We thank you for our families and our church family. Thank you for putting us on the corner at Beckman and Stafford. We thank you for the ministry that you called us to. We ask, Jesus, that you would show us our calling, that we could serve you, that we could be part of what makes your church grow. We thank you for all that you have done, Jesus. We thank you that you watch over Stella Grace and her family. We thank you that you watch over Randy and that you call to him gently to come into your fold. We thank you for the opportunities to share your love with others, now and always.
Lord, I pray for your vision for us as a church to guide us into this year and to truly see the needs around us, and that as we care and as we love others, Lord, that others would see your love shining through us and that they would want to know the reason for the hope that we have. So give us insight into 2021 and our community, and we know there are many hurting people. And we just pray that whether they're hurting just financially, physically, due to this time we're in, or whether they're hurting emotionally or relationally in other ways, Lord, there's so many people that need a word of hope, and pray that our name would, we would really live up to our name as a congregation, as a church, as leaders, and just truly see, others could see the hope that is found in you, Jesus, as we care and as we love. So bless and guide us, and as we go in those directions into this year. Thank you, Jesus.
Father, I ask your blessing on our local and our global missions, the work that is done with Food for Thought and the children that are blessed with that, for Wilsonville Food Bank, and also our global missions of especially African Smile and the work that is being done in Tanzania. Lord, your name is being brought up constantly in those villages over there. I specifically ask for a special blessing on Isaiah, who is someone who lives in the village there that we've been supporting, and he is attempting to send his oldest son to secondary school, and finances are hard. Mm-hmm. And we all know that their education is the key. If they are not able to learn the English and to go on to the schooling, that they their situations will not improve, Lord. So we ask you to bless him and help him to find a way. And thank you, though, for those that put their time in and their money and their passion and their love for you in these missions.
Heavenly Father, thank you so much for Jano's testimony. Thank you for his willingness to be that vessel, that light that sometimes that we may not see it, but it's there, and that we may say a word, or we may say a phrase, or we may just take a moment to listen. But that moment is a seed that gets planted. And I look at what he did to the people around him, that exponentially just because he took that moment. And Lord, help us to be that vessel, to take that moment and not be afraid, but know that you're there and that you're giving us words, you're giving us that time. And so thank you so much, Lord, for his moment of stillness and peace and presence of mind to show his Christian faith. And it's shared. Thank you, Jesus.
just ask you to work on those hearts that are on the fence and they're not quite sure, and just help them to open that door to see you and know that your love is there and that they don't have to be afraid again anymore. I just ask that you please be and I know we're your vessels, and I know we are to show your love through us to them, but sometimes it's hard to reach there and help them to open that door to you.
Lord, your word reminds us that in Romans 8, that the Spirit helps us in our weakness. And Lord, as we read your word, we see that even when we don't know what to pray for, the Spirit himself intercedes for us with groans that words cannot express. And he who searches our hearts knows the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints in accordance with God's will. We trust in that promise that even when we don't know what to pray or our hearts are heavy, that you hear us. You hear our groans, our cries, our pains, and that you are there for us. So thank you for that assurance at all times that you are for us, God. Thank you.
Lord, I want to pray especially for children. Children of our church and children of our community, of our families, and children of the world. Lord, that this pandemic, this and its kids that I see, has probably affected them more directly in many ways than some of the adults that I know. It's affected their school. It's affected their ability to be in a relationship with their friends, with their teachers, with their family, with their grandmas and grandpas. Lord, just pray for Tony. There's so much unknown. There's so much in the news that they see that they're exposed to. They see a crazy world. They see all sorts of things going on, and I just think sometimes they don't understand. And just be there for our children and our youth, Lord.
Lift up again a prayer for my sister Amy and the memorial service that I'll be going to today in Longview, and just she's mourning along with the family of her friend Brian, but yet I pray for just your peace to permeate that place and to cover all that gathered there today. Lord, I personally pray too for my mom and dad, thankful for their presence in this room here today, and especially lift up my dad with healing and with the breathing issues and the fibrosis he's dealing with. Just continue to cover him and my mom and sister as well as they're together. Bless them in Jesus' name.
And Jesus, we lift up to you the people in our church, like Laura, and who need work, Jesus. They need to deal with the world, and they need the abundance to be able to do that. And we pray that you would provide that, because we know that you are the great provider. It is not our government or our money or our medical world that save us. It is you. And so, Jesus, we pray that you open up work and sustenance for these folks who look to you for your help. We thank you, Jesus, for all that you have given, and we seek from you more of your abundance, Jesus.
Thank you for your prayers, and I'd like to offer a final, well, not a final, but another opportunity if anybody would like to pray, but in a moment would like to close with the Lord's Prayer. But any other prayers that you wish to just lift up before we close?
Lord, this time is so precious. Thank you so much for there's a way, still a way, for us to gather together safely, to congregate in your name. Lord, it's important for us to all remember. We worship you, we praise you, and we honor the King. And you are the only one who's our praise and our devotion, filling up our hearts and our minds with your law and your doctrine and compassion. But then we honor those who are governing us, and they are completely different. We understand they are not the same. For you are the King of all, and it is your will that is to be done. Lord, thank you for providing what's necessary for us to remember this. And Lord, thank you for giving us all that you have given, and providing a way for us to continue your kingdom, and worshiping your name, and spreading the great news of the gospel.
Thank you all for participating and praying, and let's pray together the prayer our Lord Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power,
and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. And as we conclude again, look forward to seeing you tomorrow. And as we worship the Lord, and as we praise Him, we're going to hear another testimony tomorrow from Greg Lundeen, and along with the message I give as we're continuing into the our First John series. We're almost done, and just kind of looking ahead. I'll share a little bit of our thoughts moving ahead into the vision God has for us as we get closer to the end of the month and our annual meeting, and just regular times to be thinking and planning and preparing. But I ask you pray for me, just as I'm still discerning that vision, along with our church leadership, of our direction in this year that's, again, pretty different, but that's the world and that's where we're at. And so prayers for that. And, you know, God's faithful. What he has started, he will continue, and he's not abandoning any of us or his church, but we want to have open eyes and ears to what he wants to do in and through us always. So let's pray for that individually as well as a church. So I'm going to, in a moment, share this song, Do It Again. So God will continue to do his work again and again. And
that came to me, you know, on the 21st of December, and a few days after, there was the star that was the same star as it was in Bethlehem. And then it was in 860 again, and then that star came into the sky in 2020, in December of 2020, and Henry and I saw it. It was an amazing, and it was all over the internet. I don't know how many people, how many of you saw that star. And we considered it. I looked at the sky, and I saw it, and I viewed it as a sign of hope and a great sign from the Lord that no matter what, I'm with you and there is a good news. Good news of my presence in your life. There is the star of Bethlehem. Christ was born under that star. And I know that God will not forsake us. He's always with us. And that star is a sign in these very trying times. And all is well because God is with us. And my feeling is that of joy and great thanksgiving to the Lord for that sign, for being with us, for loving us. And I pray to the Lord in the prayer of thanksgiving for all of you, for our church, for all the Christians in this world to unite in this notion of total thanksgiving and knowledge, awareness of the presence of God in our hearts, in our midst, in each other. All is well. God is with us. God bless you all.
Thank you, Tanya. What a great word to close with. And you always have a good way of putting those reminders. And just as we think of Jesus, the baby, that God's going to continue to be faithful to the world, and he has, and he is. And I think with little Jaslyn, they say a baby is a sign that the world should go on and will go on. So that's a great reminder right there, just in the earthly way of children. And so thank you for that. Well, let's sing together. You can sing this song. I think many of you know it as we've sang it at church, but let's sing this promises that as God has been faithful, he will do it again and be faithful again and again and again. So just bear with me if you can hang on.
I'm at my house.
Can you guys
hear me? It's time to worship. It's kind of weird doing this via recording, but hey, we can all worship together as we lift our voices in praise, and in our prayers, we can use this time to focus our hearts on God and petition God to move in these times. So let us worship together in song. Sing together.
Worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of
I'm going to get this right one of these days, you guys. You've been so patient with me. I'm so sorry. I got the wrong song up. It's a great song, but we did that one last time. So I'm going to try one more. Oh, goodness. All right, take 27. Here we go. One more take. If you can hang on, that's great. If you got to go, I understand. But here we go. Let's try it.
This song reminds us that we can put our faith and trust in God as we converse, as we talk, as we listen to his voice. He's faithful, and he will always be there for us, no matter how long it takes. Let's sing.
walking around these walls. I thought by now they'd fall, but you have never failed me yet. Waiting for change to come, knowing the battle's won, for you have never failed me yet. Your promise still stands, great is your faithfulness, faithfulness. I'm still in your hands, this is my confidence, you've never failed me yet. Let's sing it out. I know the night, I know the night won't last. Your word will come to pass. My heart will sing your praise again. Jesus, you're still enough. Keep me within your love. We'll sing your praise again. Sing it like you mean it. Come on. Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You've never failed. Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You've never failed me yet. Come on, let's sing it. Seen you move the mountains, and I believe I'll see you do it again. You made a way when there was no way, and I believe I'll see you do it again. Seen you move the mountains, and I believe I'll see you do it again. You made a way when there was no way, and I believe I'll see you do it again. I'll see you do it again. Come on, sing it. Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You never failed. Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You never failed me yet. You've never failed. You've never failed me yet. I never will forget. You've never failed me yet. I never will forget. Amen. Thank you guys all so much for being here, for being a part of 3 days of prayer. And I hope that this worship time lifts you up. And amen.
Amen. And God bless you all. Have a wonderful day, and let's go in peace and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.